is it? You probably know who that was. Good morning, Mount Olive. Just that was the first thing I could think of to try to do to introduce this video. Probably knew who I was when you saw the wig. Probably wasn't John. Maybe we can get John in a wig here for Friday's devotion. I don't know. But going to talk about who we are. So I thought it'd be interesting to open up there with not knowing who we are. So we're going to try to present the screen here for you. Hopefully this works. And so talking about this week in the devotion, I'm going to try to set this up for you today. Who I am in Christ. And what I'm going to do here is try to talk about knowing who you are, in Christ. So I've actually had done this devotion back, I guess, during the quarantine time. It kind of popped up there on the YouVersion app, and it was one I'd done separate. And I really enjoyed it. I hope you guys do too. It was a great reminder, especially during that time, of who we really are and taking that from God and from Jesus and not from the world. But get into more of that here later. But this was a quote from the devotion from Craig Groeschel. It says, "Being consumed with what people think of you is the fastest way to forget what God thinks of you." Talked a little bit about that in the last devotion that I did. It's something that I struggle with. It is. I'm so easy to become concerned with what people think about me, or am I making everybody happy? And of course, there's people in our lives that we want to make happy, but you know, we can't always do that. And it's not about that. We'll talk more about that here in a second. But so the big question for today, and really for the next couple of weeks probably, is who are you? Not what do you do? The devotion did a good point with pointing that out. Not what do you do, but who are you? And so I kind of split that up into positive labels. We'll start with that first. We'll start with the positive first here on Monday morning. So it's not what I do. I'm a teacher. I'm a bus driver. I love when the little kids, I've been driving a bus for 3 or 4 years now, but I love when the young kids get on the bus, and like some of them have rode my bus for 3 or 4 years and still call me bus driver. I have no clue what my name is, I don't think, and that's fine. But you know, they call me bus driver, but that's not who I am. It is to them, but that's not who I am. It's not even who my family is. You know, I'm the husband of Allison. I'm the dad of Spencer and Everly, as you see to the right there. This was a somewhat recent tea party we had. Notice how perfectly pointed that pinky is right there. Hopefully you can get the angle on that. You dads at home, take note. That's a guy that's done many a tea party. Dressed up there, by the way, that's definitely not who I am, as you can tell by my sweatshirt today. But these are all positive labels. I mean, those are things that, you know, I guess when I think about who I am, a lot of times this is what comes to my mind first. You know, I'm son of Kay and Tony. Those are all good things, but it's still not really who I am. And that's what a lot of this devotion is about, is knowing who we are. So those were some positive labels. And I guess the kind of where that goes then is negative labels. And this is, I think, where we struggle, where I struggle, is I'm not who the world thinks I am. Even if that's something that I used to be. I was listening to second devotion in a row. I think I've quoted Duck Dynasty or the Unashamed podcast. If you don't like that, I'm sorry. I kind of enjoy it a little bit. But, you know, Phil Robertson was talking earlier this week, and he was talking about, they were saying, you know, people were saying you're so forthcoming with these stories about your past, and some of them are bad, you know. And he said, why would I not be? He said, to me, that was who I was, but it brings even more light to how good Jesus has been to me, how much he's forgiven me of, and how far he's brought me. And of course, we're not all, you know, we're still not perfect. We'll get to it later, but I'll go ahead and say this now so I don't forget. But I love, Jason referenced this a few days ago in his devotion, but when Wednesday night in the Revelation study, pastor was going around and asking specific people if they were righteous. And of course, the answer was no. No, we're not. We're definitely not. I'm as far from it as you could possibly be. But, you know, in Jesus, we are. And that's the amazing thing. We'll get to more of that later. But I love that point by the pastor there on Wednesday night of, you know, are you righteous in yourself? The answer is a big no, if we're honest. But in Jesus, we can be. So negative labels, you know, I'm not who the world thinks I am. I don't know, and I'm getting better, I think, as I get older, about really not caring what the world thinks I am, but more what God thinks I am, what Jesus thinks I am. But, you know, they'll put tags on us. The devotion mentioned some of these: loser, hypocrite, immature. Immature may be, that may stick for me most days, but that's fine. Fake, lazy, you know, whatever that label may be. And maybe it's something even that's more serious than those. Maybe it's a label that at one point in your life was true. You know, and maybe that, but, you know, in Jesus, he's going to change that. We'll look at that here in a second. It's really not even who I think I am. Sometimes I think it's hard for some of us, and maybe it's just me, but if we're honest, it's hard for some of us to see ourselves in much of a good light. It's so much easier to look at the bad things I do and be hard on myself some days. But that's not who we are. If we've been saved, if we've been born again, if we've accepted Jesus as our Savior, then that's not who we are either. And it's definitely not those negative labels. So I think what we need, well, I know what I need, is a daily reminder of who I am in Christ. So hopefully this week, that's kind of where we're going with this. The other ministers will give you a daily kind of one thing to focus on each day of who we are in Christ. And so, you know, I said that my ultimate identity, you know, again, I'm a dad, I'm a father, I'm a teacher, I'm a bus driver, I'm a big goofball most of the time. Those are all things that I am or I do, but my ultimate identity, my eternal identity, is found in Jesus. It's the only place it can be found, right? I can't find an ultimate identity in anything other than something that's bigger than me, something that's eternal. So, and you know, who I am is going to be determined by who God says I am, period. I wanted to point out that there's a period there. It's not comma, who God says I am, and also, you know, what my best friend thinks about me. It's not. It's who God says I am. That's who I am. And, you know, this is something that kind of struck me, that we're so quick to be concerned with what man thinks of me or the opinion of man. But, you know, when you really, really sit down and think about it, I was thinking about this earlier this week, the opinion of Almighty God, you know, the God that we've been studying about all these things in Revelations with the different things. And of course, the Pastor's Heaven series, you know, all of, when you really sit down and think about that, man, why do we concern ourselves with what other people thinks when God thinks so highly of us or wants so much for us, right? So in 1 Samuel 16 here, of course, this is a familiar story. I love this story. This is in the Short Sisters have a little 5-minute Bible book at home that we love to read out of. And one of the stories is when Samuel's picking out David. And I love this mental image. I threw in this picture of my man Conan here from the movie Brave. I want to continue to reference children's movies because that's about what I got. But this is from the movie Brave. And what's happening here is one of the kind of leaders is they're introducing their sons to the princess, and he's introducing his son while this guy stands here, Conan. And then if you can see kind of the little leg sticking out behind, that's his actual son. And so finally, as he gets done, he makes the big guy move, and it's this little scrawny guy. And so that's where my mind went when we're talking about David here. But in 1 Samuel 16:7, of course, talking about picking David, kind of out of this lineup of these big, huge, you know, what I think of as David's brothers. But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his own countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth. I'm glad of that. For man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. And isn't that good? You know, no matter what we've done in our past, no matter who, even who you are right now, you know, the Lord can always change that, right? So looking here in 2 Corinthians for a couple things here, and just talking about kind of generally who we are in Christ. In chapter 5, verse 17, talking about being a new creature. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, so if you're saved, if you are covered by the blood of the Lamb, Pastor did such a good job on Wednesday night of those bowls and the blood offering. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. You've been covered up. You're new. You put on the new coat, right? Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. And then skip down a few verses there to verse 21 and talking about Jesus here. For he hath made himself to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. So again, back to Wednesday night, you know, he goes, TJ goes around and asks Jason, you know, are you righteous? No. Andrew, are you righteous? Definitely not. You know, he goes around but the awesome thing is we are righteous in Jesus. I certainly don't deserve that. None of us do deserve that righteousness, but Jesus gave it to us. He imputed it. He laid it on us when he took our sins on the cross. So that's who you are today on this Monday morning that maybe, you know, you're kind of dragging around a little bit, like I'm sure I probably will be. You know, you're made new. You're righteous today. Remind yourself of that in Jesus. It's nothing that we've done. It's nothing that I've done, but we are made righteous in him. And so just kind of finishing up here, love this quote, when we know who we are, we'll know what to do. So remind yourself as we go through this week, watch these devotions, you know, follow along with us, please, on the YouVersion app and comment on there. Don't be afraid to comment. I love to read new people's comments on there each day. So each day we're going to have an I am. You know, God, of course, is the great I am, but tell us who we are each day. Day two is going to be I am God's child. That's a great reminder. Day three, I am forgiven. Looking forward to that one. Day four, I am God's workmanship. And then on Friday, I am made new. And then on Saturday there, Brett will be reviewing all of those with us. And he'll have some kind of awesome background behind him. I hope. Love Brett's backgrounds. Keep those coming, Brett. But that's kind of where our week is going. So follow along with us on that. I hope that was a good setup for you and a great reminder of who we are in Christ. Remember that you are forgiven, you're new, made new, and you are righteous. So let's end in prayer here, Mount Olive and Mount Olive friends. So let's go ahead and do that. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for another opportunity, God, to come before you today. God, we are so thankful that we are made new in you, that we are righteous. We don't deserve that, Lord, but you give it to us, Lord. Remind us today who we are in you, God, not who the world thinks we are, not even who that we think we are, God, but who you think we are. That's all that really matters, God, is your eternal perspective on who we are as a person, who we are as a church, God, and help us to show the world that. Help us be the light to this world. God, as always, we ask you if there be one here in our midst that doesn't know you, God, that found this video somewhere, God, that you would start working on them right now. Convict their heart, Lord, that they would need a Savior. God, we love you so much. You are amazing, Jesus. Thank you for everything you've done for me. Thank you for everything you've done in my life. Bless this church. Bless our pastors, God, and our leaders. And just have everybody have a great day today and tell somebody about you. We love you. We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, Mount Olive. So have a great day. And somebody else will see you tomorrow. Love you guys.